Hello friends, welcome to Global Techler. In this video, we will practice how to merge two CSV files in Power BI with applying some best practices to keep model size minimum. And the question is, you have two CSV files, products and categories as given in exhibits on the right side. And from Power BI desktop, you import the files into Power Query Editor. You need to create a Power BI dataset that will contain a single table named product and fields as given in exhibit. How should you combine the queries and what should you do on the categories query? So here on the right side, we can see we have products table or CSV file where we have four fields, product ID, product name, supplier ID, category ID. And then we have another table that is categories. Under that, we have category ID, category name, and category description as the fields. And as per the requirement, we have to combine these two tables and we have to derive table product that should contain all the fields from both the tables. And in answer area, we have two questions. One is for combining the queries, what action we will perform. Under that, we have three options, append, merge, and transpose. And the second question is on the categories query, what option we have to apply, whether we need to delete the query or we need to disable the query load or we need to exclude the query from report refresh. Now let's look at the data in Power BI. So here in Power BI, you can see we have categories table and under that we have fields category ID, category name and category description. And the second query we have product. Under that we have product ID, product name, supplier ID and category ID. Now to combine these two tables, as we can see we have category ID as a reference field to the categories table. So we need to join these two tables using merge queries option. So for that, let's go to the product table. As the product table is the child table, let's go to the merge query. And here we need to merge product with the category table. So let me select the category table. And the join key between these two queries is the category ID. And here in the bottom, we can see we are getting 14 out of the 14 rows. So we are not losing any data using the left outer join. So let's hit the OK. And let me expand all the rows from category table. And here you can see we are getting all the records along with the all the fields as per the given requirement that we need product ID, product name, supplier ID, category ID, and category name and category description from category table. So now we have single table that contains all the records and all the columns from both the queries. In such case, we don't need category table over here as this is just the source or we can say reference for the product table to merge data into the product. So data that holds in this table is the duplicate data and we need to remove that data. So for that, here we have option enable load. So once we disable this, here we can see it say we will lose the data from this table. So let's click on continue. As we know, this data is already part of product table. So now as you can see in category table, the name is showing in italic format. So that means the data will be not loaded for this table. So just to verify that, let me close this query editor. And now here in the data pane, you can see we are getting only one table. The category table is not available over here as the table is disabled and data has been removed for that table. So now let's go back to our question. For the first question that combine the queries by performing as we need to combine the tables horizontally to get all the records from product table along with category. So we can mark merge as the correct option. And for the second question on the categories query, we disable the query load as we want to remove the duplicate data from the category table.